Jean-Baptiste Grenouille is dragged from his cell to be sentenced for his crimes. As the doors are opened and he's brought to the balcony, Grenouille is greeted by screaming citizens calling for his head. They announce that his sentence is a brutal, tortured death, and the crowd cheers. The severe sentencing elicits joy as Grenouille looks out onto the sea of people who hate him for what he's done. Long before the sentencing, in a foul-smelling French fish market, a woman gives birth to Grenouille. Unlike her previous stillbirths, Grenouille lives, so his mother runs away. The townspeople catch her and hang her for attempting to kill her baby, sending Grenouille to an orphanage. On the first night, the other children try to kill him, but are stopped and beaten by the keeper of the orphanage. To her, Grenouille is just money. They know something's different about this boy. Grenouille, now 5, still can't talk, but his sense of smell is unparalleled. While the other children don't hate Grenouille, they feel wary of him, somewhat creeped out. He realizes his gift is one only he had. As he continues to grow up, Grenouille eventually learns to speak, but isn't satisfied by the limitations of language, which can't fully express the scents he smells. He can define aromas from far away, around the trees and even in the water. Eventually, now grown enough, and with little room in the orphanage, Grenouille is sold off. The woman who sells him is robbed and murdered on her way home. Still, Grenouille proves resilient and adjusts to his environment, working 16-hour days as he gradually becomes aware of a world beyond the tannery. Then one day, he's taken into town for delivery and revels in the scents of the city and its people. He's greedy, wanting to experience every smell imaginable as long as they're new. While his owner's talking with his client, Grenouille wanders off, searching for a smell that's piqued his interest. He walks closer and sees the perfume boutique, and hears as the man tells the ladies he's recently created the scent. He's interrupted by another smell, and goes searching for it to find a young woman walking with a basket of lemons down the street. He chases after the mysteriously beautiful scent. She eventually realizes he's there, and as she turns to look at the stranger, she's frightened by how close he is. The woman asks if he wants to buy lemons, and takes them from her basket and holds them out. Grenouille instead goes and smells her hand. She removes her hand, afraid, and runs away. He tries to find the smell, but the conflicting aromas of fireworks make it difficult. Cinema recap here. We've got a little challenge that'll take 5 seconds, and it will change your life forever. You ready? All you gotta do is like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell, and you'll receive 10 free years of good luck. It's as simple as that. He manages to find her scent again and moves through the streets until spotting her. He creeps up behind her while she cuts away at the lemons and smells her intensely. She turns and is frightened to see him so close to her again. And as she screams, he covers her mouth and drags her backwards as two people walk into the street. They vanish around the corner and he lets her go. Unfortunately, it's too late. He's accidentally killed her. Grenouille strips her and looks for the origin of the smell he so desperately seeks. He becomes frantic as it begins to fade. Back at the tannery, he's beaten for running away. That night, he struggles to sleep, thinking of the intoxicating smell and nothing more. He realizes that the only answer is to pursue a means of preserving scents, to never lose them again. One of the more famous perfumers, Giuseppe Baldini, once celebrated, has grown out of touch. He's no longer aware of the new and exciting perfumes and scents out there, causing him to fall behind and wane in popularity. He rejects his associates' ideas that he should inspect the new fragrance by a famous perfumer to gain insight into what people are looking for these days. But in his office, he's already purchased the perfume to inspect. After smelling it, he agrees that the fragrance is good before trying to figure out the ingredients. He gets a few of the elements before struggling to fully identify the individual scents. Having fallen asleep, Giuseppe is woken to the sound of Grenouille knocking at his door. He opens it and sees Grenouille with his delivery. He brings Grenouille inside to place the skins in the basement. Grenouille asks if Giuseppe is trying to make the leather smell better with his rival's perfume. Giuseppe asks why he says that, before Grenouille tells him that he can smell it all over him. Grenouille tells him that he thinks the aroma is terrible because it has too much rosemary and other ingredients. Giuseppe asks what other ingredients are in it, and is impressed when Grenouille produces them all. Grenouille speaks out of turn, causing Giuseppe to get angry with him, but Grenouille says he can reproduce the scent for him. Giuseppe decides to give him a chance, believing he'll fail. He makes him replicate the smell in a small container. Grenouille agrees to do it, but says Giuseppe must let him do it his own way. While Giuseppe agrees at first, he critiques everything Grenouille does before watching his quick and methodical work. Finally, when Grenouille shakes the perfume, Giuseppe's had enough and tells him to leave for doing things completely wrong. Grenouille drops the vial in front of him and tells Giuseppe he's done. He reluctantly smells it and is impressed to see it was made so accurately. Grenouille says if Giuseppe lets him, he'll make the perfume again, but better. Grenouille takes the vial back and runs around, grabbing more ingredients as Giuseppe watches. He finishes it and brings it to Giuseppe, who walks away and tells Grenouille to leave without testing it. On the way out, Grenouille asks if he can work for Giuseppe to learn how to keep smells. Giuseppe says he'll think about it before closing the door on Grenouille. Giuseppe returns to the basement, smells the perfume Grenouille made, and feels transported to a stunning garden with beautiful women. He goes back to the tannery and buys Grenouille. The tannery owner dies that night after falling off a ledge and hitting his head. Thanks to his hiring of Grenouille, Giuseppe's store comes back to life better than ever. Along the way, Giuseppe teaches Grenouille the tricks of the trade, explaining that perfume is made of three main parts: head, heart, and base. Each has smaller components. But he tells Grenouille that the Egyptians believed that to create a truly original perfume, you needed to add an additional final element to dominate over the others. Giuseppe tells him about the discovery of perfume in a tomb that had retained its smell for centuries before being discovered, but nobody could identify the 13th note. While looking at the 12 notes, Grenouille thinks of the scent of the girl. When Giuseppe wakes him up, Grenouille tells him that he'll make however many perfumes Giuseppe wants, but he needs to learn how to capture scents. Giuseppe agrees. Giuseppe teaches Grenouille everything. They boil roses and extract the oils with an invention of Giuseppe's own creation. While waiting for the oils to be extracted, Giuseppe tells Grenouille of a place where perfume skills are truly tested, and only once they've conquered this place can they call themselves a true perfumer. In the morning, Grenouille goes to the river and collects a series of items before returning to the workshop. He tinkers with the extraction device, but his noise wakes up Giuseppe. He goes downstairs and sees Grenouille on the ground, surrounded by mess and broken glass. He asks what's wrong, and Grenouille says Giuseppe lied. He can't capture and retain all smells. Giuseppe's confused, but Grenouille holds up liquids to his face and asks what he smells, and Giuseppe says nothing. Finally, Grenouille reveals he intended to smell glass, something he can smell but a typical nose cannot. Giuseppe sees all the things he tried to experiment with and, in the pot, finds his cat. He tells Giuseppe that something's wrong with him before Grenouille passes out. A doctor comes by and tells Giuseppe that Grenouille's dying. Giuseppe goes to Grenouille's bedside and prays over him. Grenouille wakes up and asks if there is any other way to retain scent besides distilling. Giuseppe tells him of a specific method taught in Grasse, the city that defines a perfumer. After a few weeks, Grenouille recovers and decides to venture to Grasse. In exchange for journeyman papers, Giuseppe requests 100 new perfumes from Grenouille. Once Grenouille leaves, Giuseppe goes to sleep with 100 perfume recipes in his hand. While he sleeps, his home collapses, killing Giuseppe and his wife and taking the recipes with him. Grenouille travels to Grasse, enjoying the open and fresh air surrounding him. With two possible paths to Grasse, Grenouille follows his nose, which takes him up hills and mountains. He stumbles upon a grave nearly absent of any smells at all. One night he wakes up and finds himself making a realization that he's without scent and becomes afraid of his own oblivion, as if he doesn't exist. His plans change. He intends to go to Grasse, prove his existence, and make people believe he's somebody by creating an original scent. He arrives on the outskirts of Grasse and smells the scent of a woman approaching. He chases after the scent and shows his journeyman papers before walking around the city, searching for the smell. Grenouille jumps the fence into the woman's property and smells her as she opens the doors to her room. She walks on the balcony before going to the garden. Grenouille hides as she comes up to a tombstone that Grenouille's hiding behind. Laura's father, Antoine, calls out for her, and she goes to him. Grenouille gets a job with Madame Arnulfi, where he'll learn the art of enfleurage. A girl from the lavender fields is flirting with one of the pickers in the hay. She goes up and pushes the ladder with him down as a joke. He angrily leaves, and she realizes she's stuck. Soon she hears someone enter, and the ladder is back in place, and someone climbs up and reveals himself to be Grenouille. The following day, in the enfleurage tank, the girl floats as Grenouille tries to capture her scent. He's interrupted when a woman stops by with a delivery. She looks around and Grenouille tries to stop her from going too far. Just as she's about to look into the tank, Madame Arnulfi walks in and asks why the tank's covered. Grenouille lies and says he's doing an experiment to see if a lack of sunlight will preserve the scent of the flowers even more. Durand inspects the liquid coming from the tank and says he doesn't smell anything. When Grenouille smells it, he agrees, calling his experiment a failure. Grenouille hires a prostitute. He attempts to use the method of cold enfleurage. The prostitute becomes wary and tries to kick Grenouille out, but he kills her instead. His efforts result in successfully preserving the prostitute's scent. The next day, while the body's removed, Grenouille puts a few drops of her scent on his hand, and the prostitute's dog comes and finds him. Grenouille stalks Laura at her birthday dinner. After trying to distance herself from the bishop, the girls all play a game of hide-and-seek. Grenouille tries to grab Laura in the maze, but she runs away. With the game over, they notice the twins are missing. Grenouille killed them both. Antoine searches the maze with the other men but are unsuccessful in finding the twins. The bodies are later found in the river. Antoine suggests a curfew until the murderer's found. He's met with resistance. After more and more women are killed, a curfew is instated. Panic starts setting in as numbers keep growing. Beyond the murders, people are dying accidentally as people are afraid. Grenouille mixes the scents of 12 girls and decides it's time to get the last scent, Laura. The townspeople believe everything's okay when a messenger comes and tells them that a criminal confessed to the crimes in another town. Antoine isn't convinced, considering the killer who confessed assaulted his victims. In contrast, none of the victims in grass were ever touched in such a way. At a party, armed with the knowledge that the killer's still out there, Antoine goes to get Laura and bring her home. She refuses, and after he slaps her, she runs away from him. While alone in an alley, Grenouille prepares to grab her. As she's about to get close, her father finds her, and she runs to him. At home, he closes Laura's balcony doors, kisses his daughter goodnight before leaving her to sleep. Little does he know, Grenouille makes his way inside and goes to Laura's room to kill her. Antoine wakes up and runs to Laura's room, and when he gets inside, finds her there. And just as he thinks, he was worried for nothing, he sees the doors wide open. With Laura now considered a potential victim, Antoine sends her off away and out of the city. Grenouille chases after him, but his nose leads him in the direction of Antoine, not Laura. Durant looks for Grenouille and finds the prostitute's dog digging something up in the workshop. He goes to inspect it and discovers the prostitute's hair. He realizes that Grenouille is the killer. On the top of the hill, Grenouille smells Laura, who was with Antoine the whole time, but in disguise. Antoine and Laura go to an inn, where he rents all the rooms for the night before they'll set sail for a deserted island across the water. Everyone in town now knows the identity of the killer as all their clothes and hair are found. At dinner, Antoine tells Laura that he's convinced that the killer is still loose and that Laura is the last victim. He proceeds to tell her he's agreed for her to be married to the Bishop of Grass. Laura attempts to object, but Antoine doesn't listen. Laura runs off to her room, and Antoine locks her in to keep her safe. Grenouille looks across the river at the hotel where they're staying. While Laura sleeps that night, Grenouille prepares for the enfleurage process before going to find and kill Laura. After realizing the door's locked, he grabs the key next to Antoine's bed and enters Laura's room. She turns as he prepares to kill her and opens her eyes to see him. She doesn't scream. She just stares into his eyes. The following day, Antoine walks in and finds Laura dead. He breaks down, devastated to have lost the one person he loved most. As Grenouille finishes his perfume with Laura's scent, he's surrounded by police. He puts the perfume in his pocket and surrenders himself. They hold him up and continuously submerge him in water. Antoine asks why Grenouille killed Laura, and he simply tells him he needed her. Antoine tells Grenouille that he will be there when he dies to ensure he suffers. Everyone gathers for Grenouille's execution. They watch as the executioner practices, getting ready for Grenouille. The guards come to take Grenouille to his death. They unchain him and bring him to the scaffold. Grenouille opens the vial, and the guards all stop, bewitched by the smell. The priest arrives to bless the execution, but everyone's kept waiting. Having escaped, Grenouille puts the perfume on his skin, dresses up nicely, and arrives by carriage to his own execution. The smell causes everyone to act differently towards him, friendly, respectfully. The executioner bows to Grenouille and says the man is innocent. Everyone begins to argue. Grenouille dabs the perfume on a cloth, waves it in the air, and watches the mood of the crowd change as they all smell the powerful scent. The priest goes to his knees and calls Grenouille an angel. Everyone cheers him as Antoine watches over the proceedings in disgust. After letting the cloth loose and watching it go into the crowd, Grenouille realizes they don't care about him. They care about the scent. He watches as the townspeople devolve into an intoxicated, erotic festival of bodies. Grenouille smells the lemons that fall, thinks back to the first girl, and imagines being with her. He's interrupted when Antoine comes at him with a sword. He intends to kill Grenouille, who's ready to die, realizing he'll never get the love he desires. His quest has no fruit to bear. Durad is hung for the crimes, as everything was found in his backyard. Grenouille takes the perfume and walks away from grass unfulfilled. The perfume is powerful, but not powerful enough to make him loved for who he is. Grenouille returns to the fish market. He pours the perfume on himself. He's treated as an angel before he's devoured by a crowd of vagrants. Grenouille, by morning, is nothing but clothes, as if he never existed in the world. The perfume vial lays on the floor, a single drop left. Perfume was released in 2006 by Dark Sky Films. It starred Ben Whishaw, Alec Rickman, and Dustin Hoffman. What would you do if you learned your favorite perfume was made by using the scent of a real person? Tell me with the hashtag CinemaRecap in the comments.